Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you all children? I hope you all are fine and doing the practice regularly. Children, today we are going to start a new topic, that is time. Time is not new to you all. Have you heard some proverbs related to time? Or have you heard your parents saying, please don't waste your time, use your time wisely? Yeah, all these statements tell us that time is a very important thing. It is very precious. Once we lose the time, we cannot get it back, right? That's why importance of time we have to consider in our daily life, okay? In maths also, time has its own importance. Now, in maths, time is related with like how we are going to read the time, how we convert the time is all that we are going to learn. Today, we are going to see how we read the time. Now, if you see on the board, I have a clock where you can see the numbers are there on the clock and there are needles. We also call them hands. Now, these type of clocks, we call them analog clocks. Can you see? These type of clocks are called analog clocks. We have other types of clocks also. We call them digital clocks. Now, what do we mean by digital clocks? The word digit itself tells us what type of clocks it can be. Digital clocks means they will have only digits. There are no needles on those clocks. You don't find needles on digital clocks. You'll only find the numbers on them and there'll be dots like colons, okay, between the hours and the minutes. So there are two types of clocks, digital clocks and analog clocks. Now today we are going to see how we read the analog clocks, how we read the time according to the needles on the clock, okay. Now, before that, we have to look into some terms or the words that we use when we read the time. I hope you all know about these words. The first word that I have written here is hours. Hours means, again, it is how many hours, right? The time related to the time. Then we have the second word that I have here is minutes, seconds. Then we have hour hand, minute hand and second hand. What do we mean by hour hand, minute hand and second hand? Like I told you, on the analog clock, you will find needles, okay. Now, I have drawn two needles here. Sometimes we might have three needles also. Now, these needles are also called as hands, hands of the clock. The smallest hand or the smallest needle that you see on the on an analog clock, we call it hour hand, okay. Now, this hand points at the number and we read that hour, okay, that number tells us how many hours it is, okay. Then the second hand that you see on the clock, the long hand, this is the minute hand. Now, this hand tells us how many minutes have passed, okay. Sometimes you will find the third hand also on the clock, a fine needle you will find on the clock, that hand is known as second hand. Now, if we don't have second hand on the analog clock, still we can read the time. But in the absence of hour hand or minute hand, it is not possible for us to read the time. These two hands or these two needles are very important. Without these two needles, we cannot read the time, okay? Second hand, if it is not there also, we can still read the time. But hour hand and minute hand are very important, okay? Next, we have to know one day is equal to 24 hours. Now, in one day, we have 24 hours, okay? Then, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 60 minutes make 1 hour and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. 60 seconds make 1 minute, okay? Now, next, we are going to see using the numbers on the analog clock, how we read hours and minutes. We need to understand that the same number, how we can read it in hours and how we can read it as minutes, okay. Now, if you see on this clock, inside the clock I have written numbers from 1 to 12, okay. Now, inside what numbers I have written, they will tell us about how many hours, okay. It depends on where the needle is pointing, on which number accordingly we read the hours. Now, if you see outside the clock, I have written some numbers, few numbers I have written outside the clock. Now, these numbers are the minutes, Okay, let's try to understand how we have got these numbers. Now from 12, you know that you must have learned in your lower classes that when the minute hand is on 12, that is where the correct hour starts, right? Suppose if it is on 12 and needle is on hour hand is on 3, it will be 3 o'clock. Okay, after that, as the minute hand moves, okay, here in between 12 and 1, there will be fine lines. You can see on few clocks there will be fine lines like this. These are the minutes. Between the two numbers there are 5 minutes. Okay, from 12 to 1 there will be 5 minutes. It covers 5 minutes. From 1 to 2 another 5 minutes. From 2 to 3 another 5 minutes. So every number we pass, 5 minutes we are passing. Okay, so when we reach at 1, when the minute hand moves from 12 to 1, 5 minutes will pass. Okay, so you can see I have written here 5. So 1 means it is 5 minutes. When minute hand is pointing at 1, it means it is 5 minutes. Okay, but if our hand is pointing at 1, then it is 1 hour. Try to understand this thing. When minute hand points 1, it means it is 5 minutes. Okay, when our hand points 1, the same number but the needle is different. Okay, when our hand points 1, it means 1 hour. Okay, now next, if minute hand is on 2, minute hand on 2, it is 10 minutes. But if our hand is on 2 or facing 2, it is 2 hours. Okay, so accordingly we have to read the hours and minutes. So 3 means 15 minutes. Minute hand, if it is pointing 3, 15 minutes. If our hand is pointing 3, then it is 3 hours. Okay, so 4 means 4 minutes, 5 means 5 minutes, and so on. Now easy way you can remember is just multiply this number with 5. For example, 4, 4 into 5 is 20, so 20 minutes. Suppose if it is 7, 7 into 5 is 35 minutes. Okay, same, this number which is inside, if you multiply it with 5, you will get how many minutes it is showing. 9, 9 into 5 is 45, so 45 minutes. When minute hand is here, it will be 45. When our hand is on 9, it will be 9 hours. Okay, this is how we have to read the time. So we will try to read the time which is shown on this clock. Now you can see here, our hand is facing or pointing towards 3. So it is 3 hours, right? 3 hours. 3 hours. Then the minute hand, you can see the minute hand, it is on 1. 1 means how many minutes? 5 minutes. So 3 hours, 5 minutes, right? The time that is shown on this clock is 3 hours and 5 minutes. So we can write it as 3:05. This is how we write the time. Okay, in digital form, in digits we write it like this. See, there are colons or the points over here. The before the points we write the hours, and after the points we write the minutes. Okay, so the left side of the points we have hour, and the right side of the point we write minutes. So it is 3 hours 5 minutes. This is how we write the time. Okay, I hope you have understood how to read the time. Okay, we will practice with few more clocks on the board. The first clock that I have here, you can see that the hour hand is pointing towards 4. Okay, so it is 4 hours. Okay, then you see where is the minute hand? Minute hand is pointing towards 2. 2 means how many minutes? 2 means it is 10 minutes, right? So if we have to write 4 hours and 10 minutes in digital form, then we will write it as 4:10. Understood? 4 hours, 10 minutes. Hours and minutes. Okay, either side of the points. To the left side we write hours, and to the right side we write minutes. Okay, the next example that we have here, you can see, now you can see that the needle, okay, this hour hand is between 4 and 5. it has moved slightly away from 4, right? It is between 4 and 5. Children, you all should remember that as the minute hand starts moving from 12 and goes round the clock, the hour hand also moves slowly towards the next number, okay? It will not stay at one place, right? It has to go to the next number. So, as the minute hand moves faster compared to the hour hand. So, hour hand will slowly move towards the next number. So, here you can see the minute hand, when it has come from 12 to 6, all the way from 12 to 6 it has reached here. Slowly the hour hand also has moved from 4, okay, it has come between 4 and 5. But when we read, we have to read with the previous hour. We should not read it with the next hour, we have to read the time with the previous hour, that is 4. So, how many hours? 4 hours, okay. Again it is 4 hours and 6 minutes, sorry, minute hand is on 6. So, 6 means how many minutes? 6 means it is 30 minutes. So, 4 hours 30 minutes, how will we write it? 4 hours 30 minutes, okay. Now, we will see one more example. In the third clock, again you can see that the hour hand is very close to 7, okay, the next hour, it is very close. See, the minute hand has had started from 12 and it started moving around the clock and it has reached 10, okay. So, as it has moved round the clock, the minute hand, as it moves round the clock, the hour hand also moved towards the next number or the next hour, okay. So, here you can see the hour hand is close to 7, but it is not a complete, it has not completely been 7. We have to still read the time with the previous hour, that is with 6, okay. Once it reaches 12, once the minute hand reaches 12, then we can read it with 7. But till it does not reach 12, the minute hand does not reach 12, we have to read it with the previous hour, that is 6. Okay, I hope you are understanding this. When the minute hand moves round the clock, okay, at the same time the hour hand is also moving towards the next number. But when we read the time, we have to always read with the previous hour, unless and until the minute hand does not reach 12, okay. Now, here you can see it has not reached 12, it is still at 10. So, we have to read with the previous hour, that is 6. Okay, here we will write it as 6 hours and then we have to look at the minutes. Now, minute hand is on 10. 10 means how many minutes? 5 into 10 is 50. So, when minute hand is pointing at 10, it means it is 50 minutes. So, 50 minutes. So, 6 hours, 50 minutes. If we have to write the same time in digital form or in numbers, we write it as 6 and then 50. 6 hours 50 minutes. I hope you have understood how to read the time on an analog clock when we have hours and minutes. Children, please remember that the same number will be read in two different ways. If you are reading the hour, it will be the number that it is pointing at, and if you are reading it for minutes, we have to convert it in 5, like multiply it with 5, you will get how many minutes it is. Like 1 means 5 minutes, 2 means 10 minutes, 3 means 15 minutes and so on. So, please keep practicing of all that we have discussed today, and inshallah we will meet very soon with our next topic. Till then, stay at home and be safe. Jazakumullahu khaira. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.